Hey buddy, it's John with Upstate Brush Control. We're back here on a project we were at about 6-8 months ago, where we did the 1,700 foot long driveway. We did a bunch of clearing, stuff like that. So their house is coming along. They're getting close to drying it in. Looks like they got a few more windows. They got HVAC going on the inside. But we are back over here. There's the driveway we put in right there. We'll throw a link into those other videos we did on the driveway. So the customer called me up and asked us to come back, touch up the woods real quick. And I say real quick, this is day two. Touch up the woods and then bush hog the field and everything. So I was not able to get over here yesterday, just due to my plan was to come out, but I got tied up looking at jobs and work and stuff like that, which I much rather be out on the job. I'm thankful for the work and that get the opportunity to go look at more jobs and work and stuff like that, but at the same time I like doing this part of the Upstate Brush Control, not necessarily the looking at jobs. Anyways, so I wasn't able to make it over here, wasn't able to get any video on this, but the guys, Willie, Josh, and Micah, they bush hogged all this with the skid steer, bush hog on the skid steer, and then they Ventrac that section over there. Josh is touching up around the house. There's a few things that fell over here on this side of the property, some sticks and limbs and stuff like that. So piled it up over here, brought the grinder. But the plan was today to take out this big old tree right here, because his pool, they're gonna be putting a pool back here and it's too close to it. Has a pretty hard lean towards the house. I really didn't feel comfortable with taking it out. Maybe if I had the 130 over here, but I don't think it'd be worth it. Drag it all the way down here just to push over one tree. So I got a buddy who's coming this evening to look at just getting it on the ground, then we'll do all the cleanup on it. All right, so we're gonna go put the bush hog on and then finish up some bush hogging down over here on this side. Man, I was excited. We're gonna use a stump X, drop that thing, haul that log off. But I didn't really remember it too well. It's got a pretty nasty lean towards the house. It helped to get the weight out of the top of it. So the guy's gonna come, he's got a bucket truck. He'll come and take all the weight off and drop the pole, no problem. If it wasn't so, have I done sketchier? Yes. Have I done things I shouldn't have done? Yes. Should I just do it? No. Not worth it. I'm not a tree guy. I can't cut a tree down here and there, but got the old bush hog on down here. I haven't used this thing forever. Make sure my pins are in. Pins are good to go. This is a low flow. Just your standard flow deal. Nothing fancy. Here we go again. This does not happen.
what it is, if you don't hit that release, this is a pressure release right here, if you don't hit that whenever you go to, take it off.
Real quick, just kind of go over what we're doing here. So as you can see, this material behind me, it's all overgrown. A lot of it is resprout and just weeds that have come back up. This area was forestry mulched about 6-7 months ago, something like that. So it looked like how this is right here. It went all the way through this. If you forestry mulch, you have to maintain. People think once you cut it, that's it, it dies. It does not die. It is something that has to be kept up. You don't have to necessarily force your mulch it again. You can run over it with a bush hog. If you keep it down a little bit lower, you can run over it with a weed eater. I've even had customers run over it, raise up the deck on a mower, run it over with a mower. I wouldn't recommend it with a high dollar mower, but you know what I mean. So like an old beater or something, you know? But this area through here, we forestry mulched up to that those big cedars right there. From there up, we grubbed it out. We made it, and we threw out some grass seed in that area. Looks like we got some seed down here. There's some grass, but just kind of trying to educate people on forestry mulching. Once you mulch it, it is not, you're not killing anything. You are not, it will regrow is what I'm getting at. Like this tree right here, this was probably underneath that is probably a 6 to 8 inch stump. I don't know, maybe a little bit smaller. This is regrowth. That is regrowth. These are regrowth. That's just little grass and weeds and stuff. But you're not actually killing anything whenever you forestry mulch. So keep that in mind. If you guys are looking at jobs, if you're wanting forestry mulching done, it does have to be maintained. If you will let it go, it's going to grow back up and it's going to look like that right there. All that right there is what this area looks like. So just trying to help people out. I get a lot of questions about that as far as from customers and from contractors who are looking to get into the business. So I'm going to go through bush hog this area down, whack it back. right, so I finished up all the bush hogging down here. That's all wrapped up. We got all the weed eating done. I'm gonna head off to take this back to shop, and Josh is gonna go hit the front again.
Go mow, baby.
Show him that big deck and everything.
All right, so I'm mowing out here with the Ventrac. I'll show you when we get out there. All right, so we got the old Ventrac with the 95-inch deck. I already did a couple passes. So we're just cleaning up what the bush hog did. It left some piles of grass and stuff. So I'm just running over it real quick, chopping those up, and any stragglers that were left. Here's John. Yeah, that's about it.
Well, I don't know how much that you guys could see, but Josh just got a little bit more right there he's gonna hit. It clumped up real bad with the bush hog on skid steer. It's pretty tall, I guess. I never actually saw it, but yeah, we kind of, I don't know if he explained it to you or not, ran that way just to help with the, give us some stripes and, you know, add a little character to it. It looked pretty cool. But we're gonna get loaded up over here real quick as soon as he's done. Still working? Oh, we're still working. All right, we're heading out. We're all loaded up, strapped down, wrapped down. Oh, that's not good. It's like you got a squishy tire, Josh. But we are out of here. We'll be back in a couple days to pick up the Ventrac, and we got to get the price on getting those two trees out, that one right there and the other one over there, get those taken down, and then we're going to clean them up. So hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, comment, all that good stuff, and we'll see you on the next one.